All right, we have with us Senator Risa Ontiveros. Good morning to you, Senator Risa.
Good morning, Karen.
All right, I want to ask you first, let's talk about what were your thoughts with Senator Alan Peter Cayetano's opposing the filing of a resolution before the UNGA? Does this resolution mean we are anti-China, or now it moves to us being pro-US? Because it seemed that during the interpellation, the arguments moved to that realm.
The resolution, co-sponsored by SP Migs, Senator Jinggoy, and Senator Raffy, was not about the US or any other global power. It was about China, of course, because siya yung subject ng ating historic win sa The Hague. But most of all, it was about the Philippines. Kaya, well, nung nakita kong tumayo si Senator Cayetano, I wasn't completely surprised dahil hindi naman ito yung unang pagkakataon that he did not support pressing the case against China. And napakasimple naman, Karen, nung resolution namin. It is expressing the sense of the Senate to urge the Philippine government through the Department of Foreign Affairs to sponsor a resolution in the UN General Assembly calling on China to respect and to comply with that Hague ruling and to cease and desist from her harassment of Philippine vessels in the West Philippine Sea. A simpleng expression ng Senado bilang isang independent institution of what we feel the executive may further do. At hindi po ito mutually exclusive sa any and all other political and diplomatic moves that the Philippine government should take. So yes, it was a bit surprising, but then again, given his history of sort of easing the Philippine foot on the gas pedal vis-a-vis China, I have to confess I wasn't completely surprised.
Okay. Now, Senator Ontiveros, why did you decide to give that privileged speech that particular moment in time? Why that time? You have Philippine vessels that have been harassed. I would have to say we're seeing the numbers right in the news in the last few months. Why the other day? Why that?
I guess, Karen, it was to really capture the growing international consensus that we are seeing, that the Philippines is enjoying, of more and more countries, even more and more regional formations, getting behind us on this issue of the Philippine national interest in the West Philippine Sea vis-a-vis China's bullying. Mm-mm. So, kumbaga may buwelong nabubuo. So, and kasunod ng historic win nga natin sa The Hague 7 years ago, we should really press the case, press our case, not just at The Hague, kung saan tagumpay na tayo and that stands for all time, but continuously in the court of international opinion and therefore also in any and all other international fora, including the United Nations. Kumbaga, hindi dehado pero may advantage na tayo dito. So let's take the ball and run with it.
Okay. Now, what difference do you think it will make if the Philippines brings this to the UN General Assembly when the victory of the Philippines, the arbitral tribunal decision, is actually its final? In a way, yes. It's legally binding, but then it can't be, as they say, it can't be implemented or exercised on the ground. What difference would this make?
The difference it could make is to really complement our victory at The Hague, which is complete in and of itself. Kumbaga, perfect na siya bilang ruling ng, kumbaga, judiciary, isang judiciary sa global stage. But a UN General Assembly resolution, if adopted and as sponsored by the Philippine government through the DFA would parang yung resolution namin sa Senado at the UN, if adopted, it would express the sense of the United Nations, of the community of nations, na dapat talagang kapag may tagumpay ang isang bansa, lalo na a weaker state vis-a-vis a stronger state, pag may tagumpay sa isang global court, it should be respected. It should be complied with. So what we're trying to do here, Karen, is after that beautiful win at The Hague, to capture the sense of the states of the world that this is now an international norm. At hindi ito magiging unang pagkakataon, Karen, ha? Nicaragua has done this previously in the UN General Assembly in 1985, if I remember the year correctly. May tagumpay din sila dun naman sa International Court of Justice against the United States. So again, halimbawa ng isang asymmetry of power, a weaker state versus a stronger state. Hindi sinusunod noon ng US ang ruling ng ICJ to cease and desist in her actions against Nicaragua around and inside that country. 5 beses pinagbotohan sa UN Security Council. Finally, it was brought to the UN General Assembly. And there, Nicaragua was upheld. Merong ding isang kaso o resolusyon sa UN General Assembly dinala ng mga dating colonies ng Portugal. And again, those smaller or weaker states were upheld by the UNGA.
Yeah. So I think in a way it makes a difference that the issue with the West Philippine Sea is once again put in a global platform. That's the difference there. Now, at the end of the day, while there is a Senate resolution, before the DFA can actually bring this forward, it would have to have the go signal of President Marcos Jr. I believe that at one point you called out Malacañang for what you described as its deafening silence on the anniversary of the country's arbitral victory last July 12. And yet the president has kept insisting, even in the sauna, that we will protect our territorial integrity, our sovereignty. Not an inch will be given away. What else would you want to see the president do? He's taken quite a different stand, or at least even in foreign policy, compared to the previous administration.
And that's where I can agree with the president, Karen. He has pinihit niya yung position natin. He's made a good start in terms of the direction of our foreign policy, away from almost exclusively friendship with Beijing to a wider community to include not just the US but other global powers, other countries, and other regional formations in the world. And ito namang resolution, kinikilala pa rin na siya ang architect of foreign policy, ika nga, at ang kanilang alter ego dyan ay ang DFA. In fact, in my sponsorship speech, I recognized that the final execution of this course of action, kung i-adopt ng Senado at kung mamarapatin ng executive, will of course be in the able hands of the DFA. But kailangan kasi mas may gawin tayo. Nakukulangan pa talaga ako sa aksyon, hindi lang ng DFA, ni Presidente mismo. He did repeat in the sauna those words about upholding sovereignty. Yeah. He had said in the campaign he would not give up one square inch of Philippine territory. Pero yung upholding sovereignty sa sauna, sabi niya, through dialogue. Hindi na nga sumusunod ang China kapag dialogo. Ito nga ang Hague Tribunal ruling, dinededma niya. So one thing the president could have said in the sauna that he didn't, deafening silence, hindi niya sinambit yung mga matatamis na salita na West Philippine Sea o Hague ruling.
Very interesting that you noticed that.
Kasi I was hoping, against hope, babanggitin niya, he did not. So that is something that he still could do, that with the DFA, he still could do. Any and all international platforms or fora are open to our country. Kasama na ang UNGA, kasama na sa pamamagitan ng isang resolusyon ng gobyerno.
And you believe that in terms of symbolism and stressing a certain point mentioning the West Philippine Sea, meaning the words West
Yes.
Philippine Sea would have made a difference in the sauna.
It certainly would have kasi magiging senyales sa ating lahat ng mga Pilipino na okay, si Presidente, architect of foreign policy, panghahawakan talaga niya at gagamitin this single most powerful, peaceful, non-violent, political and diplomatic weapon in our government arsenal to uphold Philippine national interests in the West Philippine Sea. At magiging senyales din siya sa China na, oops, you know, for the first time in what, 7 years, the Philippines is going to really take the ball and run with it.
Okay. Now, just recently, General Centeno was appointed as presidential advisor on the West Philippine Sea. What do you make of that appointment? And do you think it would help actually deal with China's aggression?
Yes, the point of view of the defense and armed forces establishment is always important in crafting our foreign policy, lalo na sa ganitong mga areas na may tensyon o conflict pa nga kasi hinaharas yung di lang yung ating Philippine Navy, yung ating Coast Guard, yung ating BFAR, pati at higit sa lahat yung ating mga mangingisda. So to have the former chief of staff of the AFP, now the presidential advisor on the West Philippine Sea, I think is important, not just symbolically, but again, in practical terms. Kasi halimbawa, itong recent incident na ininterdict ng China, yung ating resupply mission ng Philippine Marines sa PRP Sierra Madre sa Ayungin Shoal. Wow, I am really looking forward to General Centeno's views on that, how they may be expressed by the National Task Force on the West Philippine Sea at pati ni Presidente at pati ng DFA. Kasi ano yan? Nagbubuo ang China ng blockade laban sa atin. Gusto nilang i-starve out yung ating mga kababayan, yung ating mga Marine personnel sa Sierra Madre, sa Ayungin. Hindi talaga. And I think I'm hoping and I believe that the Philippine Navy would know best how to take care of its personnel, our personnel there. And I'm sure that kami sa Senado at harinawa sa buong Kongreso will give them full legislative support in the steps they will take. And I hope the president will be up to that task as well.
Okay, now moving on to the sauna, just a few more questions to go before we run out of time. How did you find the president's sauna overall? And what do you think should he have focused on more? What kind of the state of the nation did you want to hear?
How did I find it? I could hardly find it, Karen. Yung sinabi niyang state of the nation, hindi talaga kumpleto o makatotohanan. At yung state of the nation, yung Philippine nation nilalarawan niya sa sona niya. There was only one hit among many misses at yun yung condonation nung utang ng ating mga agrarian reform beneficiaries. Pero ang daming misses talaga. There were so many other issues that he could have spoken on in the first place and spoken on more completely and truthfully. Halimbawa, just to give examples, yung PUV modernization, yung araw na yun mismo, our jeepney drivers held a strike. So nasaan na yung roadmap ni Presidente dyan? Sinabi nila na yung mga pagkain daw sa hapagkainan ng mga pamilyang Pilipino ay nagmura na. What country was he speaking about? Kasi kung tanungin natin, lalo na yung ating mga mahihirap na pamilya, hinding-hindi totoo pa iyon na mas abot kaya ang nutrisyon at pagkain sa atin. Another deafening silence, Karen, anti-corruption. Well, of course, he said bilang na daw yung mga
Okay, Senator Risa. Okay, we lost her a bit. Let's see if we can get her back. just to
Okay,
finish.
can you hear
Okay,
me now?
yeah, go ahead. Continue, Senator Ontiveros. Go ahead.
Well, another deafening silence in the SONA was anti-corruption, especially against agricultural smuggling and large-scale or economic sabotage. Although sinabi ni Presidente na bilang na daw yung mga araw ng mga smuggler, well, he has to put his money where his mouth is. Unahin na niyang tugisin yung mga favored importers sa sugar fiasco. Number two, sugar smuggling. And unfortunately, kailangan niyang singilin din yung accountability ng mga matataas na opisyal nila sa Department of Agriculture at pati sa Office of the Executive Secretary sa handling ng sugar fiasco na iyan. Of course, binida ni Presidente yung Maharlika Fund, but until now, after his ill-advised signing of that bill into law, kahit nagsusumamo talaga yung ating 20 ekonomista mula sa UP halimbawa at naghahanda yung ating mga mamamayan hamunin ang constitutionality niyan sa Korte Suprema, isang malaking sugal pa rin, Karen, ang Maharlika Fund sa ating mga Pilipino. Tama ba yon na yung mga pondo natin at yung kinabukasan ng ating mga anak at apo ay gawing sugal ng ating gobyerno? Inflation, of course, binida ni Presidente, bumaba na daw. But, you know, inflation, even a drop in inflation, is just words and numbers hanggat maranasan sa araw-araw, no? Sa sikmura ng ating mga kababayan at hindi pa rin dama na lumusog ulit yung yung kanilang mga sweldo o sahod, because inflation means salary cut, and until now Filipino families will tell us hindi pa rin maramdaman na bumalik ang buying power para sa mga produkto at serbisyo na kailangan natin sa araw-araw. Shocker, Karen, yung employment numbers ni Presidente.
Okay.
I was taking notes of his sauna. Napatingin ako, what?
But wouldn't the president get that from the agencies?
Yes,
I mean, clearly,
for sure
he would get that data from the agencies.
Yes, but the OP would vet the numbers and, of course, work with him to finalize and perfect his SONA. You know, Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel reminded me that pag ang isang ekonomiya is at 95% employment, that's already full employment. So, is the president telling us more than full employment tayo? Ting hindi. And yung kanilang underemployment figure of only 11%, that is grossly understated. When we talk employment, kailangan pag-usapan hindi lang yung bilang ng mga trabaho. And even there, you know, 600,000 jobs shed in agriculture alone in the last year. And we have to talk about the quality of the jobs. Sa ngayon kasi, jobs of last resort pa rin yung nage-generate. Mga low productivity and low wages jobs. At hindi pa nagde-deliver yung sinasabi ng government economic managers na drivers of growth, manufacturing, mining, high-skilled services jobs. Hindi pa rin, Karen. So I really don't know which nation the president was describing the state of. Way off the mark siya. Pati sa renewable energy, sabi nila last year, the use of renewable energy is at the top of our climate agenda. So nasa na yun, no? Sa panahon ngayon ni Bagyong Egay, edukasyon,
right.
And okay. Health, Karen, way behind pa tayo at hindi tinalaki ng ganap at makatotohanan ni Presidente.
Okay, so overall, we don't have enough time, but Senator Risa, what do you think should the President, you've mentioned in detail, even areas that you believe should have been fact-checked, but what do you believe the President should focus on? Would it be really inflation and the price of basic commodities?
Definitely, Karen. Kahit sa mga surveys yan ang lumalabas na top of mind, top of heart, top of sikmura, concerns nating mga Pilipino, lalo na ng karamihang mahihirap, walang kapangyarihan, at overall, yung ang laki ng mandate niya eh. No? Huwag niyang sayangin yung pangalawang taon niya. No? Let him ride that momentum and prove to us Filipinos that his administration is one that can keep its promises.
On that note, Senator Risa Ontiveros, always a pleasure to speak with you. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Karen.